Hey everybody and welcome back to another Python scripting tutorial. In this video we're going to be looking at how to create a custom shortcut or a hotkey or key mapping, whatever you want to call it. We're going to create a shortcut to one of our operators. So for example, I'm going to press Shift F and then it's going to open up our dialog box. So the first thing we need to do is go ahead and load up our scripting layout. If you have one, go ahead and load it up. If you don't, just scroll through here and find the scripting workspace. Then go through this and tidy it up. We don't need any of these. I'm going to make sure we enable word wrap, and also I'm going to get rid of the Python console. We don't need it in this example. Okay, so I'm also going to press A, select all of this, and then press X, just delete them. Don't need any of these as well. So as I mentioned, I want to create a shortcut to one of our operators. So instead of pressing N, go into the object header, and instead of pressing a button that brings up the dialog box, I would like to press a shortcut, which is going to be Shift F, and then this will bring up a dialog box. So that's what we're going to be doing in this video. Go ahead and open up the operator that you want to use. If you don't have one, I'll make sure to leave a link in the blog so you can go ahead and download the template script. So I'm just going to go ahead and open it up. So this is one of the dialog tests that I did. So if we run the script now, it just opens up a dialog box, which we can add a cube, change the scale, add an array, rotate it, just do a few things I was messing around with. So instead of pressing run script to bring up this dialog box, what I need to do is go down here, just get rid of this test call. So we just use the hash key just to mute this. There we go. So now when we run script, nothing happens, which is good. So to add a shortcut, what we need to do is first make sure that the shortcut is not being used. For example, if I press Shift F in the 3D view, nothing happens, which is good. If something did happen, then I wouldn't be able to use that shortcut. But again, you can use a different key if you want. So let's go to the register and just add some space here like this. So I'm first going to create a reference called addon underscore keymaps and equals, and this is going to be a list, so we need to open and close brackets. Then in the register, make some space here. Then after we've registered our classes, so let's type wm equals bpy.context.window underscore manager. Then I'm going to reference the key configuration, so we're going to type kc equals. Then we would need to type all this out again, but since we've already referenced it, we just need to type wm dot key configs dot addon, hit enter. If kc, then add a colon, hit enter. Then we can add a new key map. So I'm going to type km equals, and again, instead of typing out this and this, we're just going to use the kc reference. So km equals kc dot key maps dot new. Then open and close parentheses. Then inside here, we're going to type name equals apostrophe twice. Then in between here, I'm going to type 3D view like this. Add a comma. And then we need to define the space type. So where is this going to be shown? So space underscore type equals. And then in this, I'm going to show this in the 3D view. So this is going to be view underscore 3D in capitals. So we're going to type view underscore 3D. So what this is doing is creating a new key map within Blender. So if we go to edit, then to preferences, and if we go down to key map here, then if we scroll down and we find the 3D view, 3D view global, we can see here this name refers to which section within the key maps it's going to be added to. So when we run the script a little bit later on, it will add a new section here so we can come back and check this a little bit later on. So this is just defining the new key map. So the next thing we need to add is the key map input. So KMI equals KM dot key map underscore items dot new. So now within here we can define which operator we want to run and which key we want to use. So I'm going to add quotation quotation. Then in between here we just need to type the ID name of the operator that we want to run. So we can see, we go back up here, we see we've got this dialog operator. So I'm going to copy this ID name, scroll down, and then in between here, I'm just going to paste this in. Then after the quotation, I'm going to hit comma. Then we want to define the type. So this is going to be which key that we want to use. And I'm going to use the F key. hit comma, then type value equals, then apostrophe twice. In between here and in capitals, we want to type press. So then after this, if we hit comma, then I'm going to type shift equals true. And if you also wanted to use control, then you could also type control equals true as well. But for this example, we just want shift F to run this operator. Then hit enter. Now I'm going to type add-on underscore keymaps dot append, then open and close parentheses, then inside here, open and close parentheses again. Then in between here, we're just going to type these two references, so KM, comma, KMI. So now we've appended these two, we can go to the unregister. So right after this unregister here, I'm going to type for KM, comma, KMI in add-on underscore keymaps. Then add a colon. So we're saying if the KM and KMI is inside the keymaps list, then we want something to happen. So I'm going to type km.keymap underscore items dot remove, and then open and close parentheses. And then inside here, I'm just going to type KMI. And if we hit enter and then press the left arrow key, just so we're in line with this, and then we can type add-on underscore keymaps dot clear, open and close parentheses, and that's it. So now if we hit run script, and then if we go over to the 3D view and hit shift F. So I'm going to pause this and just try and figure out what's wrong. Okay, so it took me quite a while to figure that out, but it's just this space here. It shouldn't have a space right here. I mean, for other examples, it's okay to have a space, but for this example, for some reason, you don't have a space. I don't know. So I'm going to save this. And then if we run script, and then now if we press shift F, there we go. Now we have our pop-up dialog box. So we go back to the preferences. We can see now it says add cube menu, shift F. So make sure you get rid of that space if there was one. Also make this template available to download. So if you want to use this as a rough guide, or if you want to use this in your own project, you'll find the link in our blog. But yeah, hopefully you found this video helpful. If you did, be sure to give this video a like. As always, thanks for watching, and I'll see you next time.